Good afternoon, everyone. Today we will start with a new chapter, that is money and Indian banking system. So there are two well-known and important terms, that is money and banking system. There are two important pillars of our financial system, money and banking system. Today we will only focus on the matter of money. Today we will discuss the definition and the functions of money. Okay, let's start. Money basically a material which is acceptable to all as a medium of exchange and work as a unit of measure of value, standard of deferred payments, and the store of a country in a fixed era in called money and in economics. A material which is acceptable to all as a medium of exchange and work as a unit of measure of value, standard of deferred payments, and the store of value of a country in a fixed era is called money in economics. Basically, money which is prescribed by the law of a country, in our country India, which is prescribed by the Reserve Bank of India, which is our central bank. So money is called legal tender money in our country. We all know there are two types of money. One is coin, that is metallic coin, and one is printed paper note. We call the note. Clear? So there are four functions, which is there is four functions which inconsistent in the definition of money. There are number one, medium of exchange, number two, the unit of measure of value, number three, the standard of deferred payment, and number four, that is store of value. So we will discuss the four functions in our class. First function, that is number one, medium of exchange. The first and most important functions of a money, that is the medium of exchange. Before the innovation of money, direct exchange of commodity with commodity takes place in the barter system of our financial system. The main problem of the barter system of exchange was the inconsistency of the demand among the persons engage in exchange, that is, exchange was not take place in the absence of consistency of demand among the persons engaged in exchange. Innovation of money solved this problem. In reality, transaction activities, that is, the money exchange commodity with the commodity, become more easy as all the persons agree to accept money as a medium of exchange. In other words, it can be said that the main functions of money is to make transaction system easy and simple by the removing the main problem of inconsistency of the demand in barter system of exchange. So the first function we can focus, that is the medium of exchange, because it is acceptable by the society and all of the people of the society. If money can acceptable by the society, all people, so it is in the earlier age before the money before the innovation of money, in the earlier age, before the innovation of money, shells, gold, silver are treated as money. When they are used as a money, they were generally accepted. That is, most of the people in the society would accept them in payment of goods and services. Basically, money is used for repayment of debt, and they are using as a purchase and selling of goods and services. So the first and foremost, first important function, that is medium of exchange. Now we will discuss the second one, that is unit of measure of value. Number two, the unit of measure of value. Now the money worked as a unit of measures of the value. Basically, in the barter system of exchange, accurate unit of measure of the value of the different commodities was absent due to the existence of many exchange rate. Exchange rate of every commodity in terms of money and price of every commodity in terms of money are possible to express due to use of money as a medium of exchange. As a result, determination of price of each commodity become more easy. For example, if the price of 1 kg rice is 30 and the price of 1 kg wheat is 15, so we can accommodate that the 1 kg rice is equal to value of 2 kg of wheat. In this way, it is possible to determine the value of each commodity by comparing the prices of different commodities. But there is a problem, because every commodity, there is no basic medium of exchange. So the value of the money in terms of commodity should be remained constant to act money as an accurate unit to measure of value. So the value of money will remain constant when the price level of the commodity remain constant. Value of money changes if price level of the commodity is changed. Value of money decreases as the price level of commodity increases. On the other hand, value of money increases as the price level of the commodity decreases. Thus, value of commodity cannot be correct in terms of money if the value of money changes. Okay, now the third point, the standard of deferred payment, that will be discussed in next time. Okay, now the third point we will discuss, that is the standard of deferred payment. Now money is considered as a standard of deferred payment. Actually, credit is accepted on the basis of future payments, that is for deferred payments. So in the barter system of exchange, taking credit and granting the credit is much more difficult, because in that system, taking credit and payment of credit both were taken place in terms of commodity. So, as a result of innovation of money as a medium of exchange, creditors give the credit in terms of money and the debtors take the credit in terms of money. The advantage of this system is that the creditor can get return of the money with interest. In agreement regarding interest payment exists. This function of money is very important, because the present day credit oriented modern economy, as a result of the function, credit market is also trained to expand. So the value of money in terms of commodity should be remain constant to act money as an accurate unit of standard of deferred payments. So the value of money will remain constant only when the price level of commodity remain constant. So stability in the value of money is very essential for these functions of money. Clear? Now, the fourth point, that is the store of value, that will be the discuss in our class. Now the next and the last point, that is the function of money, that is the store of value. Basically, money act as a store of value because wealth mainly saved in terms of money as a liquid asset. Actually, money is a frozen purchasing power. People can save money for future expenditure or for exchange. People can give this purchasing power to others or surrender the authority upon this purchasing power for a fixed period of time. Apart from this, purchasing power can be converted into other forms. So, for the money is called liquid asset. Money is called store of value as the value of commodities of the society in terms of money have kept like a frozen purchasing power at the hands of the people. So, apart from this four function, basically money is a modern economy, performs other some secondary functions. So, but there exists great controversy among the economists regarding the functions of money. According to classical economics, they say that the only function of money is medium of exchange function. That is, according to them, main function of money is the medium of exchange function. But according to Keynes, the money is the medium of exchange, as on the other hand, it is store of value. The unit of measure of value and the standard for deferred payments. Professor Keynes first explains the money as a wealth. Now, what is wealth? Basically, wealth, we can say that is a saved money in our bank account or saving account, etc. But wealth in the economist says that wealth meaning not only the liquid asset, it is included the gold, silver, any other property that we can repurchase and resold. Clear? So that is, the money is only not only the wealth, the properties, the gold, silver, anything is called wealth. According to him, money is not only wealth and it is more liquid than all other wealth. For this liquidity, money is functioned as a store of value along with the medium of exchange function. It must be noted that the thing which performs the function of money must be acceptable by everybody. In modern system, the Reserve Bank of India, that is the central bank of our country, India, they are prescribed what kind of coins and what kind of notes are printed on a paper, and that is called the legal tender, because the Reserve Bank of India are prescribing that which kind of money, that is which kind of denomination we can use for the purpose of purchasing or selling or repayment of any debt or repayment of any goods and services. So the material which is acceptable to all as a medium of exchange and work as a unit of measure of value, standard of deferred payment and store of value of a country is called money, basically in our economics. The amount of money rotated in the economy is a fixed period of time of a country is called supply of money. Basically, there are different methods of measurement of money supply because economists are divided regarding the concept of money. Quantity of money supply can be measured with the help of four systems, that is M1, M2, M3 and M4 with the help of four elements. But we will discuss it in the next class. Today we will only focuses with the four functions and the definitions of money. That's all for today. Thank you.